is Harsh here and welcome back to Technoloop. If you are looking to buy a smartphone in the 25 to 35,000 rupees price category, then you are very lucky because there are some awesome phones in that price bracket right now. Exhibit A is the Redmi K20 Pro and Exhibit B is the OnePlus 7. Both of these phones are very good for the price point and that creates a very big confusion for a lot of you guys out there. Now today in this video, I'm going to try to clear that confusion and I'm going to tell you which phone is good for which type of consumer. And if you belong in that category, then you can definitely go ahead and buy that specific phone. Now in this video, I'm going to talk about the differences, like the major differences between both of these phones, rather than talking about the similarities. So I'm going to focus all my energies on the differences between both of these phones. Now before I get into the video, both of these phones do come with a glass back panel. That's why a case would be highly recommended for these phones, and I personally use cases from Rhino Shield is a very good company. They have some awesome cases that provide very good protection and look good as well. They do not add a lot of bulk to your smartphone, which is like the cherry on the cake. Now a huge shout out to Rhino Shield for sending over some cases for me to try out on my OnePlus 7, and they work really well. They also have a very good screen protector called as the impact protector, which will give you protection on the front side as well. So check them out by clicking the link in the description box below. And as a bonus for all of you guys out there, you can avail a 10% discount by using my code, that is Technoloop. So go ahead and order your cases from Rhino Shield and don't forget to use my code Technoloop for 10% off. Now with that out of the way, let's get to the differences between the OnePlus 7 and the Redmi K20 Pro. Now the first major difference is in terms of the software experience. So OnePlus 7 comes with Oxygen OS, which is very close to stock Android, and the experience is very clean and minimalistic. Like, they have very good features which are actually useful, and you will absolutely love the software experience on the OnePlus 7. On the other hand, Redmi K20 Pro comes with MIUI, which is a very different approach towards software experience. That experience is also good, but it is for people who like to customize their smartphone a lot. So if you are a person who likes to change the icon pack, the theme, the colors and all those things, then MIUI is actually better for you. On the other hand, if you don't want to play around with customizations a lot, then I would suggest that Oxygen OS on OnePlus 7 is actually better. I personally like both of them and I can be happy with either, so that doesn't matter for me. But as I mentioned, if you like customizations, go with the Redmi K20 Pro. On the other hand, if you want a clean and minimalistic setup, then go with the OnePlus 7. Now what about the actual software performance? Well, OnePlus 7 has a better software performance because their software is more optimized and you also get better updates with OnePlus. So OnePlus is very fast when it comes to updates and they are very regular as well. And they will support your phone for at least 3 years, whereas Xiaomi will give you support for about 2 years, like 3 years is not guaranteed. So when it comes to the overall software experience and updates and performance, I would say OnePlus 7 is the clear winner over here. Now the next major difference is in terms of the display. So the OnePlus 7 comes with a teardrop notch. It doesn't have that full screen display. On the other hand, the Redmi K20 Pro has a full screen display without any notch and it looks much more cleaner. Now both of these displays are AMOLED with a 1080p resolution, so that's pretty same. But when it comes to the color science and brightness level, I would say Redmi K20 Pro is slightly better than the OnePlus 7. I've used both of these phones and I've had a better time on the Redmi K20 Pro while consuming media, playing games, or you know, in general navigating through the UI. So when it comes to the display, Redmi K20 Pro is actually better. Now the third major difference between both of these phones is in terms of the cameras. So Redmi K20 Pro comes with a triple camera setup. So you get a wide angle camera, a normal camera and a telephoto camera. On the other hand, OnePlus 7 has a dual camera setup. There is the primary camera and coupled with that you get a depth sensor which is used for portrait mode and all those things. When it comes to the front camera, both of these phones have a single front camera, but on the K20 Pro you get a pop-up selfie camera because of the full screen display. So the pop-up selfie camera is actually a very fancy feature and some of you out there might want to show off that feature, so for that Redmi K20 Pro is really good. Now when it comes to the actual camera quality, Redmi K20 Pro is better than the OnePlus 7 and that is because of the camera software. So camera software is way better on the K20 Pro that will give you very good images. Even the wide angle camera on the K20 Pro is surprisingly good. I did not expect the K20 Pro to perform so good when it comes to the cameras. So in terms of the camera experience, K20 Pro is actually way ahead because it has three different focal lengths and you can play around with them. and it's a perfect camera phone for that price point. So if camera is your main priority, then Redmi K20 Pro is the clear choice. Do not even think about OnePlus 7. So those were some major differences between both of these phones. Apart from that, if you don't care about these things, you just want a good phone with, you know, good support and good after-sales service, then you can go with either of these phones because they are very good and you will be happy with either of them. But if camera is your main priority, then you can go with the Redmi K20 Pro. On the other hand, if performance and software is your main priority, then I would suggest OnePlus 7 is better because Oxygen OS is awesome. So I hope that this clears your confusion between the OnePlus 7 and the Redmi K20 Pro. And if you still have any more doubts, you can always message me on Instagram, or you can, you know, ask your questions in the comment section down below. So anyway, that's been it. Thank you so much for tuning in, and I hope that this video helped you out in some way or the other. And if it did, then please let me know about that in the comment section down below. Also, if you haven't yet, please subscribe below because it would mean the world to me. My name is Harsh Punjabi. I'll see you guys in the next one.